Now, the days are finally getting longer, and before we know it, we'll be dusting off those bikinis and heading for the beach. So now's the time, especially Mike, so now's the time to spring clean your fitness regime. Personal trainer Selena McPhee joins us in the Harvey Norman Lounge. Good morning.
Morning, Mel.
Really nice to have you in the studio, Selena.
Thank you. It's lovely to be here.
So if we have perhaps been hibernating a bit over winter, how do we get back into that exercise?
Yeah, look, I think planning is key to succeeding in what you want to do, obviously, and choosing something that you enjoy. So for instance, if you don't like running, don't run, you know, start with something you actually really enjoy. So if you like swimming, start with the pool and things like that. You like cycling, start with a bike, perhaps okay. A stationary bike.
Right, so you can actually really start with anything is better than nothing though, isn't it?
Absolutely, starting with something, even walking is better than nothing.
Because it is so easy over winter just to sit on the couch and eat chocolate and watch Netflix.
Absolutely.
So easy. And so
totally.
As well.
Exactly.
So what is the biggest mistake you find that your clients make?
I find they make over-exercising and under-eating. That's the biggest mistake I think people make. They tend to exercise a lot too often or maybe a bit too much and not put enough into their bodies.
Winter and they're finding that their jeans aren't fitting properly and they get a bit of a scare.
Yes.
So they go straight back into it, but
yes.
They're exercising maybe every day?
That's it, maybe even twice a day I find some people.
Really?
Yeah, really overdoing
those
it.
Those people?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. No,
so
that's what they
what
do.
What do you recommend then if you're getting back into exercise after a bit of a time off? What should you be doing per week?
Yeah, look, I think 30 minutes a day, maybe up to an hour, if not every day, every second day, being active.
Okay, just try and do something, get active, even just get outside and go for a walk.
Absolutely, get outside, go for a walk.
Sorry, you keep going.
A 30-minute walk is better than nothing.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
And exercise, obviously, very good for the mood as well.
Absolutely. You create endorphins, Mel, which makes you happy, and happy people just aren't sad, therefore they keep exercising.
Happy people aren't sad.
Yeah.
That's the best quote of the
day.
That's
it, yeah.
So what kind of goals have the best chance of success?
I think achievable ones. When you think of your goal on a whole, don't think of it as perhaps 10 kilos you want to lose. Think of it as let's cut that goal down and maybe think of it as something more achievable, like a kilo a week. That's far more achievable than looking at the big goal, which is 10 kilos in the end. Once you actually start to hit that perhaps kilo a week, then you'll actually start to see your goal in line.
What do most people come to you for? Like, I'm thinking women and men. Do women come because they want to lose weight and men because they want to lose weight as well, or do they have different reasons?
Inevitably, women come because they want to lose weight, but I find as the time goes on, they actually start to really enjoy it, and it therefore becomes a lifestyle more so than about weight loss.
Yeah, they want to get strong.
Absolutely. Strong, fit. It's the new in, Mel.
Yeah, it is. It is. Actually,
it is.
Strong Fit is the new one. It's the new black.
It is.
Is it best to mix it up and try some new form of exercise, or should you find something that you like and just stick with that?
No, definitely mixing it up. You need to shock the body, Mel, in order to keep getting better. If your body gets too used to something, therefore inevitably it gets used to it, and you stop burning as many calories because you're used to it. So you've got to keep mixing it up, changing it up. It's really good, and you don't get as bored either.
So when you say mix it up, should we be doing different things every week, or should we maybe do something for a month and then try something different?
Perhaps something for a month, try do it for 4 weeks and then change it up, try something new, or adding something into the mix perhaps to change it up as well.
Now you run box and ride classes. Why have you combined those two forms of exercise?
Yeah, well, where do I start, Mel? Okay. So the benefits to boxing and cycling, they're both low impact. You have one for upper body, one for lower body. If you're 80 years old, you can do it, and if you're 12 years old, you can do it. There's absolutely no age limit on it. You can make it as intense as you like, or as easy as you like. Everybody can do it.
Yeah, and the thing about it is that I've actually done a few of these classes.
I know.
Really
and
enjoy
you're great.
It. Really enjoy it. You know, the best part about the boxing bit?
What?
Very therapeutic.
Yes, absolutely. I think every woman would agree.
Had a bad day, just get out there and go for it.
That's
and also
it.
The cycling bit is really great for the legs, isn't it?
Absolutely,
any
yeah.
keys when you're cycling, what you should be doing?
Pressing down with the heel of the foot. We want to activate our glutes, obviously, so we're working our butts like every lady would. And making sure our hands are nice and relaxed. I think it's important to have all the weight in our legs so that our legs are getting the majority of the workout.
And working that biggest muscle in your body.
Absolutely.
Isn't it?
Burn more calories, Mel.
And keep the shoulders from getting too
taut. Absolutely. Taut.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's so much fun. I absolutely love it. I thoroughly recommend it. Box and ride, so much fun.
Yes.
And short too, which is good because it's all you can do.
I know.
Hey, Selena, it's been an absolute pleasure. Great advice as well.
No
Thank you
worries.
Very much.
Thanks, Mel.
Now, for more on Selena's classes, you can check out the website or follow SMPT on Facebook.